Greetings, everyone. This video, we will bring the second tutorial of the ACP Workbench, explaining the bass enhancement function. Many friends prefer heavy bass effects when listening to music, but they do not know which frequency band to adjust or how to adjust it. If you also have the same problem, be sure not to miss this video. The product used is BDM3, and the software is the ACP Workbench. As the BDM3, BDM9, and BRU5 all use the BP1048B2 Bluetooth and DSP chip, the operations are the same. The basic operations have been demonstrated in detail in the previous video, so we will not focus on demonstrating them again this time. If you are still unsure how to operate, remember to review. Connect BDM3 to the computer. Open the ACP Workbench, and wait for the parameters to load successfully. The audio module page is the basic audio configuration and does not need adjustment. We click on the audio effect page and find Music Virtual Bass and Music Virtual Bass Classic, both of which can be used for bass enhancement effects. Let's first look at the software manual. Page 25. Page 27. It can be seen that these two functions are similar, both enhancing bass by setting the low frequency cutoff frequency and bass intensity. You can choose either of them. Here, we choose Music Virtual Bass for demonstration. Click the switch in front of Music Virtual Bass to enable it. Input the low frequency cutoff frequency, which ranges from 30 to 300 Hz. The cutoff frequency means that music below this frequency will be enhanced, and the extent of enhancement is controlled by the bass intensity. For example, if we set the low frequency cutoff frequency to 180 Hz and the bass intensity to 50%, audio signals in the 20 Hz to 180 Hz range will be enhanced by 50%. So, how should this cutoff frequency be determined? First, according to the manual, the input range is 30 to 300 Hz, so the value we input must be within this range. If you want to know the music spectrum, you can use a spectrum analyzer to listen to the sound being played or use software like Adobe Audition to open the track and see its spectrum. Typically, unless it's classical music, the main energy of most electronic music is concentrated in the low frequency range, with the 50 to 400 Hz range possibly accounting for 90% of the total energy consumption. Generally, 20 Hz to 40 Hz is sub-bass, such as thunder, kick drums, organs, and bass guitar sounds. Proper enhancement can make the music sound strong and powerful, but excessive boosting may make the sound muddy. Of course, in this range, there are mainly electronic instrument sounds. Do not believe that organs actually reach this low frequency. Probably very few in the world can achieve that. Also, do not believe that gunshots purely reside in this frequency range. Such sounds are more like impulse responses and can be found across the spectrum. 40 Hz to 150 Hz is the bass frequency range, which is the foundation of sound, with its energy accounting for 70% of the total audio energy. When this part is lacking, the audio may sound weak and thin. With moderate enhancement, the bass sounds appropriate, making the music fuller and softer. However, excessive boosting can make the sound muffled, decrease brightness, and enhance nasal tones. Nowadays, with many electronic instruments and to suit small speakers' needs, a lot of electronic music sense of volume is often placed in this frequency range. 150 Hz to 500 Hz is the mid-bass range, which forms the structural part of the sound. When lacking, the sound is soft and weak. With appropriate boosting, it feels rich and strong, enhancing the sound's power and loudness. Excessive boosting can make the bass sound harsh. You can choose the cutoff frequency point based on the effect you desire. Also, consider your speaker's parameters. We all know that speakers have a resonance frequency point, F0, and some mistakenly think F0 is the bass frequency point, which isn't the case. Taking the WONDOM 2.5-inch full-range speaker as an example, based on the impedance curve, we can see that its F0 is approximately around 115 Hz. In the parameter table, the sensitivity given is 81 dB. So, in the frequency response curve, if we take 81 dB as the center and expand about 6 dB above and below, we will get a range. The frequency range within this range can be considered the effective frequency range of the speaker. It can be seen that the effective frequency range of this speaker is roughly 90 Hz to 5 kHz. Frequencies within this range can be compensated for by adjusting the EQ due to the sensitivity drop not being too severe. However, around 50 Hz, for instance, since the sensitivity has dropped by about 20 dB, simply adjusting the EQ no longer works. With every doubling of power, sensitivity increases by 3 dB. A sensitivity difference of 20 dB means almost needing 14 times the power to achieve the same loudness. For instance, at 120 Hz, 10 watts may be enough for a certain loudness level, but at 50 Hz, 140 watts may be needed. In reality, the speaker in the 20 to 50 Hz range does produce sound, but the same loudness level requires significantly more power, which is neither economical nor rational. Different speakers are suited for different purposes. Therefore, when setting the base frequency point, you can first look at your speaker's frequency response curve, find the effective frequency range of the speaker using the method we mentioned, and choose a base frequency point within the effective range, avoiding F0. Considering the length of time, I won't demonstrate it here. Interested friends can try it themselves. If you found this video helpful, please kindly consider liking, sharing, or leaving a comment. Thank you for your support and valuable feedback.